Daily Evening Prayer, Wednesday, December 27, 2023. Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent according to your promises declared to our people in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven. O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices. O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. When the Lord overturned the captivity of Zion, then were we like those who dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongue with shouts of joy. And they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. Indeed, the Lord has done great things for us already, whereof we rejoice. O return our captivity, O Lord, as when streams refresh the deserts of the south. Those who sow in tears shall reap with songs of joy. He who goes on his way weeping and bears good seed shall doubtless come again with joy and bring the sheaves with him. Unless the Lord builds the house, their labor is in vain who build it. Unless the Lord keeps the city, the watchman keeps vigil in vain. It is in vain that you rise up early and take rest so late and eat the bread of toil, for he gives his beloved sleep. Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is a gift that comes from him. Like arrows in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth. Happy is the man. Happy is the man who has his quiver full of them. He shall not be ashamed when he speaks with his enemies in the gate. Blessed are all those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. For you shall eat of the labors of your hands. It shall be well with you, and happy you shall be. Your wife shall be as a beautiful vine upon the walls of your house. Your children like the olive branches round about your table. Indeed, thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you out of Zion. May you see Jerusalem in prosperity all your life long. May you see your children's children, and may there be peace upon Israel. Many a time have they fought against me from my youth on, may Israel now say. Indeed, many a time have they afflicted me from my youth on, but they have not prevailed against me. Their plough is ploughed upon my back and made long furrows, but the righteous Lord has hewn the snares of the ungodly in pieces. Let them be ashamed and turn backward, as many as hate Zion. Let them be as the grass growing upon the housetops, which withers before it grows up, which does not fill the hand of the reaper, neither the bosom of him who binds up the sheaves, so that those who go by see not so much as the Lord prosper you. We bless you in the name of the Lord. Out of the deep have I called unto you, O Lord, Lord, hear my voice. O let your ears consider well the voice of my supplications. If you, Lord, were to mark what is done amiss, O Lord, who could abide it? For there is mercy with you, therefore you shall be feared. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits for him, and his word is my trust. My soul waits for the Lord more than watchmen for the morning, more than watchmen for the morning. O Israel, trust in the Lord, for with the Lord there is mercy, and with him is plenteous redemption. And he shall redeem Israel from all their sins. O Lord, I am not haughty, I have no proud looks. I do not occupy myself with great matters or with things that are too high for me. But I have stilled and quieted my soul like a weaned child upon his mother's breast. So is my soul quieted within me. O Israel, trust in the Lord from this time forth forevermore. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Song of Songs, beginning with the fourth chapter, the first verse. How beautiful you are, my darling, how beautiful you are. Your eyes are like doves behind your veil. Your hair is like the flock of goats that have descended from Mount Gilead. Your teeth are like a flock of newly shorn sheep which have come up from their watering place, all of which bear twins, and not one among them has lost her young. Your lips are like a scarlet thread, and your mouth is beautiful. Your temples are like a slice of pomegranate behind your veil. Your neck is like the Tower of David. Built with layers of stone on which are hung a thousand shields, all around shields of the warriors. Your two breasts are like two fawns, twins of a gazelle that graze among the lilies until the cool of the day when the shadow flees. When the shadows flee, I will go my way to the mountain of myrrh and to the hill of frankincense. You are altogether beautiful, my darling, and there is no blemish on you. Come with me from Lebanon, my bride. You shall come with me from Lebanon. You shall come down from the summit of Amana, and from the summit of Sinir and Hermon, from the dens of lions, from the mountains of leopards. You have enchanted my heart, my sister, my bride. You have enchanted my heart with a single glance of your eyes, with a single strand of your necklace. How beautiful is your love, my sister, my bride. How much sweeter is your love than wine, and the fragrance of your oils than that of all kinds of balsam oils. Your lips drip honey, my bride. Honey and milk are under your tongue. And the fragrance of your garment is like the fragrance of Lebanon. A locked garden is my sister, my bride. A locked spring, a sealed fountain. Your branches are an orchard of pomegranates with delicious fruits, henna with nard plants, nard and saffron, spice reed and cinnamon, with all the trees of frankincense. Myrrh and olives along with all the finest balsam oils. You are a garden spring, a well of fresh water and flowing streams from Lebanon. Awake north and come, wind of the south, make my garden breathe out fragrance. May its balsam oils flow, may my beloved come into his garden and eat its delicious fruits. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my spirit. In God, my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things. And the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel as he promised to fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke, beginning with the 22nd chapter, the 54th verse. Now they arrested him and led him away and brought him to the house of the high priest, but Peter was following at a distance. After they kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter was sitting among them. And a slave woman, seeing him as he sat in the firelight and staring at him, said, "This man was with him as well." But he denied, saying, "I do not know him, woman." And a little later, another person saw him and said, "You are one of them too." But Peter said, "Man, I am not." And after about an hour had passed, some other man began to insist, saying, "Certainly this man also was with him, for he too is a Galilean." But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are talking about." And immediately, while he was still speaking, a rooster crowed. And then the Lord turned and looked at Peter, and Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had told him, "Before a rooster crows today, you will deny me three times." And he went out and wept bitterly. The men who were holding Jesus in custody began mocking him and beating him, and they blindfolded him and repeatedly asked him, "Prophesy," saying, "Prophesy, which is the one who hit you?" And they were saying many other things against him, blaspheming. When it was day, the council of elders of the people assembled, both chief priests and scribes, and they led him away to their council chamber, saying, "If you are the Christ, tell us." But he said to them, "If I tell you, you will not believe, and if I ask a question, you will not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the power of God." And they all said, "So you are the Son of God." And he said to them, "You say correctly that I am." And then they said, "What further need do we have of testimony? For we have heard it ourselves from his own mouth. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God." Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this faith, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. Shed upon your church, O Lord, the brightness of your light, that we, being illumined by the teaching of your apostle and evangelist John, may so walk in the light of your truth, that at length we may attain to the fullness of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, out of the mouths of children you manifest your truth, and by the death of the holy incense at the hands of evil tyrants, you show your strength in our weakness. We ask you to mortify all that is evil within us, and so strengthen us by your grace, that we may glorify your holy name by the innocence of our lives, and the constancy of our faith even unto death. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who died for us, and now lives with you and the Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, you have given in your holy begotten Son to take our nature upon him and to be born of a pure virgin. Grant that we, who have been born again and made your children by adoption and grace, may daily be renewed by your Holy Spirit through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit and the same Spirit be honor and glory now and forever. Amen. O God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labor, and the repose of the dead, we thank you for the blessings of the day that is past, and humbly ask for your protection through the coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning hours through him who died and rose again for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night. Give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary. Bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted. Shield the joyous and all for your love's sake. Amen. O God the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forbearers, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation, good Lord, deliver us. From all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity, good Lord, deliver us. From all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil, good Lord, deliver us. From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, for hardness of heart, and contempt of your word and commandments, good Lord, deliver us. From lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine, good Lord, deliver us. All oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared, good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, by your coming again in power. Good Lord, deliver us. In all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment, good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God. That it may please you to rule and govern your holy church, your soul, in the right way, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To limit all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known all to all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give all your people increase of grace, to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep all your people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to rule the hearts of your servant, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, to shield them in all dangers and adversities, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To make wars, to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That may it please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To preserve all who are in danger by reason of work or travel, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To care for those who have lost children or faced infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. that it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant that we may attain to your heavenly kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard. We have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies, defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts. Mercifully forgive the sins of your people. With favor, hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure. And grant that in all our troubles, we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life. To your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.